All right, gonna do a quick unbox and overview and shoot at the range today. CB Life 1-6 power LPVO, little tactical rifle scope, red and green illuminated dot, reticle I should say rather. Comes with the cantilever mount there. As you can see, this is a 30 millimeter tube. Got your little flip up caps here. As I said, red or green, you can see the red there. And then there you can see the green. Comes with the batteries. I'm going to have to get those installed so I can show you the illuminated reticle. We'll take it home tonight after the range trip here today as well, and I'll get you some low light shots with that illuminated reticle on both collars. Obviously, this would be your battery cap. You just unscrew that. Windage and elevation adjustments here. They are half MOA adjustments, being an LPVO. They also have zero reset or turret reset capability. You would just pull this little center cap out here. After you zero it, let's say to get your zeroed, you got to end up clear up here, okay? At 100 yards, for example, you can pull this dial off via the method I just mentioned, bring it back to zero there without changing your zero at 100 yards, then put the dial back on. That way you can start back out at zero. So for further shots and windage adjustments out in the field, it'd be a lot easier to start off from zero from making your MOA adjustments. So it's a half MOA adjustment per click at 100 yards. So that would shift it up half an inch, up 1 inch. You go to two, you're gonna be up 2 inches, and that's the purpose for wanting to be able to reset it at zero after you got it zeroed for your rifle. All right, under your scope caps here, which are removable front and rear, you got a diopter here, so this is fast focus. So if it isn't quite focused for your eyesight, you just turn this to adjust the focus. There's our zoom right there. It goes from 1 to 6x, as I said. Let's try that out. Okay. Pretty easy to turn there. Obviously, I already turned the top dial, but it's got good audible click feedback, and I can feel it very well. No mush in it. So those are nice. There's your hardware. Looks like they give you extra screws because I got all my screws in there, so those must be extra. And which ones are they? They are... okay, they're all the same. So they send you some extra screws, so that's nice. The wrench you need for them there. As I said, comes with batteries for the illuminated reticle, which we'll try out later when it's darker. But noticing these always come with awesome instructions. It's got a 1-year manufacturer's warranty right there. There you can see the battery cap and whatnot. There's a quick explanation of the reticle there. I'll go over that more.
In a nutshell, this gives you various different reference points for windage and elevation holdovers, but also that center circular reticle there in the center is a bit of a range finder. If you know your distance on, like, say, a white-tailed deer, depending on how large it looks in that reticle, will kind of tell you the distance. But all these little marks here are reference points. The vertical ones, obviously, for bullet drop. You'll have to just kind of fine-tune it with your rifle and whatever caliber you're shooting. It gives you different points of reference for bullet drop. And the same for windage. You know, if the wind kicks up 5 miles an hour, 10 miles an hour, 15 miles an hour, whatever, you're going to have to test it out with your cartridge to know exactly what point of reference to use and what scenario.
But there's a little rundown of the specs there if I didn't have it in the video already. 1 to 6X, obviously, as I said, red and green, illuminated. You got 5 different brightness settings. The eyepiece is pretty large there at 35.5 millimeters. The objective lens here at the end, 24 millimeters. As I already said, it's a 30 millimeter tube. You got close to a 4-inch eye relief there, 3.9 inch. And as I also said, half inch MOA adjustment at 100 yards. Or half MOA adjustment at 100 yards, excuse me, not half inch. It'll be close to half inch within fractions of a millimeter, but still. These are waterproof, shockproof, and fogproof. They are nitrogen purged. Should be able to handle a 308 cartridge. They're rated for 800 Gs of shock, which, per my research, that's about a 308, 30-06, in a medium weight rifle. And of course, if you're shooting something like an AR, the semi-automatic action actually reduces the recoil slightly over a bolt action rifle. So anyways, I'm gonna get this thing mounted up and we'll get to shooting. All right, there she is all mounted up. And the eye relief on this thing is amazing. Let me show you that real quick. So with it set all the way down on 1X here, for one, the eye relief is just massive, so you never have to worry about this thing coming back and kissing you in the face. Even if you set your stock super close like that, the eye relief is amazing. And that's on 1X. I can go clear up this close and still see the whole picture, and then come back clear back here and still see the whole picture. Now that changes a little bit once you turn the magnification all the way up, but not much. So right there is about perfect, which again, that's a good 4 inches of eye relief. But I can come, not that you'd ever want to come this close, but I can come clear up here and still see the full picture, and not till about there until I start to lose the picture. So insane variable of eye relief on 1X, and it's pretty good on 6X too. That's crazy. So anyways, got my target set up there, 40 yards. It's got some prior holes in the center there from the previous scope review. I'm gonna work on getting this thing zeroed, and then we got some targets to shoot out here, 150 yards. I got this, 1/6 scale buffalo at 150 yards, and then I put my 16 inch steel gong there on the 200 yard mound. And yes, it's windy, if you can see those flags flipping around in the wind there. That's a pretty good looking setup, if I do say so myself. By the way, guys, this is a 7.62x39, so a decent amount more recoil than a standard 5.56 cartridge. So I like to use those because it's a pretty good test for these scopes. Plus, this thing's quite a rattle trap. It's a budget rifle, mil-spec Anderson. So the added recoil of that cartridge and the fact that that thing's a rattle trap, a real good test for durability on these scopes. We're on paper, a little off to the left. So we had that center four shot group there already. I was aiming center and we hit that little red dot there on the left. So let me make a few adjustments here. So I need that to move about 5 inches to the right. At 100 yards, that'd be roughly half inch per click. So it's gonna be a quarter inch per click there at 40, actually a little bit less, but that should be close to 1 inch. All right, that should have us close there. Now I'm gonna aim for that red dot that we hit. It's probably still gonna need some fine tuning, but it should have got me close there. You see we got 1, 2, 3 there. So we're a little low and still a little off to the left. I gotta bring it over just a hair more and come up some. Pretty close, as you can see there. Second shot pretty much hit the same first shot. I think I messed up the third shot a little. So I got my elevation right. I just went a little too far to the right, so I'm gonna give it another click or two back to the left, but she should be good to go now. I'll get you guys zoomed in the targets in a minute, but I'm gonna take 3 shots at that buffalo at 150 yards, and then I'm gonna take 3 shots at my steel gong at 200 yards. You should be able to hear it on camera on the impact.
Didn't have my mag set all the way. I just put a few more in and stuck it in. Apparently it wasn't seated correctly. Now the gong at 200. Might have shot too high on those last two.
I was aiming high on it to compensate for drop, but I probably aimed too high. But you should have still heard the two hits. All right, if this stays put, you should be able to see me hit the buffalo twice first, and then that gong out there, top of your screen. Buffalo again, 150 yards, 16-inch gong, 200 yards. You will see water splash up when I shoot the buffalo. It's just the fragments of the bullet hitting the water puddle under it. Yeah, I was just aiming too high on those previous shots where I didn't have you guys zoomed in. That time I just aimed dead center on my gong, hit it no problem. Might be a little high, might be a little low, I don't know, but either way I was aiming way too high to begin with. Remember, we just got a 40-yard zero, so if you're wanting to shoot 100, 200 yards, that's what you should zero it for, at least 100, and then learn, you know, your corrective holds for bullet drop. But we just had a real rudimentary zero there on 40 yards, so...
All right, here we are. Ooh, heat lightning. Just had a storm roll through, and there's still some heat lightning in some of these clouds. Anyways, obviously it's pretty much completely dark.
If I can get this to focus, I might have to do this in pictures with voiceover. There we go, that's not too bad. So the center of your crosshair there is right in front of that dark spot in front of that car down there. You can kind of see the holdover marks in the grassy area there, but up in the dark area in front of the car there, you cannot see the center crosshair, and that's what the illuminated reticle is for. Not only is this going to obviously work when it's completely dark out like right now, but even low light conditions where it's not quite completely dark like this, but also not broad daylight, it's going to help you out a lot too against dark backgrounds like that.
Now this is going to move on me each time a little bit, but
here is the green. That's the other thing too. This is a very nice, vibrant green, but through the camera here, it just kind of whites it out, but it's a very nice colored green. That's actually on the lowest setting. If we go all the way up, okay. I mean, you can pretty much tell all the way up is just way too bright, so you're going to want to have it on the lowest setting. It's not too bright in complete darkness like this on the lowest setting,
but if it's not quite completely dark, you know, it's like dusk or what have you, you have, I think it was 5 different settings. You can adjust your brightness that way. It's the perfect setting for you depending on your light situation.
All right, here's the red. See how it's nice, pretty red there until I get this camera down here and it doesn't quite look right on camera. I can't even get it to focus. There we go. See how it like whites out once my camera actually focuses? So it's that real nice red color. That's on the lowest setting there.
And then once again, obviously on the brightest setting with it being completely dark out. That's just too much. But again, that's what you want for those light, low light conditions where it's not completely dark like it is right now. You're going to need it to be a little brighter for you.
So anyways, final thoughts on her. Pretty nice little scope. Honestly, can't really be beat for the price for an LPVO. You know, a lot of the name brand companies, to get a 1-6 LPVO, you're talking at least $300 or $400. And a lot of times they can run a lot higher than that. This one comes in very low, just over $100. You can find some name brand for like, I don't know, maybe in the 200s, but they're only a 1-3 power, whereas this is a 1-6 power.
Field of view at 100 yards on 1X. So no magnification is 107 feet. Field of view at 100 yards on maximum magnification of 6X is 17.5 feet. But as you can see here from the still frame, we're focused in on that target down there at 40 yards. And here's that same target on 1X, so no magnification. So as you can see there, it is true to power. 1X looks like 1X. And please keep in mind, it's difficult to get my camera to focus through the scope, so it is much more clear and crisp in real life to the actual eye. Now here we are at 6X on the same target at the same distance of 40 yards. And here I have it focused in on an entire 100 yards further than what we shot today in this video at the 300 yard mound. And there's 1X on the 300 yard mound. And there's 6X on the same 300 yard mound. And again, please forgive my camera for not being able to focus very well through the scope. And if you ask me, guys, that definitely brought us way closer to that mound there at 300 yards. So I would, in my opinion, it's definitely true to zoom at 6X there.
Plus with this, you get that illuminated reticle, red or green. But I really have no complaints. It looks really good on the rifle. It's nice that it comes with these flip-up caps. Like I said, the turrets work real nice. Good feedback on those. Good click on both of those. As you saw me zeroing it on 40 yards, I got that pretty quick, so they seem to be pretty precise to about what they're supposed to be. As far as being a half MOA click at 100 yards, obviously that's different at closer or further ranges, but they seem to be pretty precise. Cantilever mount seems to be pretty heavy duty. The all the hardware snugged up real nice for me, and I tend to over tighten my stuff, and I didn't have any issues with them stripping out or anything like that. They feel real nice and solid.
I'm gonna have to wrap her up here, guys. This video is getting a tad long. You know, for the price, you can't beat this thing. And honestly, that 30 millimeter cantilever mount that it comes with, you'd be hard pressed to find that for 20 or 30 bucks just for a cheapie. And the one that comes with it does not feel like a cheapie. It's well made. So really, when you factor that in, you're only paying like 80, 90 bucks for this 1-6 power LPVO, which is a steel. I really like it, especially for the price. No complaints. Works well. Does everything it should. Holds zero. Comes with the flip-up caps, the illuminated reticle, the re-zero capability, super clear glass and reticle at the price point. And don't forget that awesome eye relief that I displayed earlier in the video. Link in the description if you want to check it out. Also, if you want to check out anything else you see me use in my videos, like my shooting bag there, earmuffs, safety glasses, paper target stand, paper targets I use, steel targets, and more. Links in the description for those as well. Really appreciate you guys stopping out and checking this one out today, and I hope to catch you on the next one.